All right, YouTube. The episode that we've been waiting for. Episode number 4. In this episode, we are taking on Liverpool away at Anfield. And then a home leg against Olympiacos. First leg of the Champions League. First game of the Champions League, I should say. Big week ahead of us that is going to greatly affect the top of the Premier League table. I'm going to simulate some of the trainings for the week. Have 5 messages. Looks like our scout is done in Spain. I'm going to send him to France. Try to scout that area. Got a youthly scouting report here. Very high on, got a good goalkeeper here, Blake Thompson from United States. Potential to be up to a 91. This is one of our big studs, Daniel Prieto from Spain, 15 years old. Potential 75 to 94. We obviously hope he hits that 94 mark. A couple more guys, Sinan Yildiz, 93 potential. And Cesar Lozano can potentially reach a 94. Have a couple other guys. They win Smart, 93 potential. He is already 18 years old, though, so he's going to have to start making some strides here. We might have to see what we're going to do about him. Another 93, Hugh Dyer, 17-year-old. He's 52 right now with potential to be a 71 to a 93. Obviously, we hope all of these kids hit and we get some future studs here for our squad. Some more scouting editing reports. The youth, 84. We're going to reject him. We do have... I'm going to sign all these guys that are potential to be in the 90s. I think that looks like that is it for... Oh, no, we have 85. I'm going to reject 83. Reject 94. But my squad is full. 84, I'm going to reject this guy. 84, I'm going to reject... 16-year-old. Potentially be a 94. Let's see if there's anybody we can let go of. This kid's not panning out. 17-year-old potential to be a 76. We're going to release this player. That's why we sign a lot. They're not all going to pan out. So we'll give William Hewitt a chance. And then we get to the last. We're going to reject all these other guys. I do want to take a shot at Devin King, potentially 94. Let's see who he can replace. I'm going to keep this guy. Although he's 84, he is a goalkeeper, and he's American at 16. So we're going to give him a shot. We don't need 2 80 potential goalkeepers. So Zachary Wade... Only one potential to be higher. His ceiling is lower at 65 or 66, and he is a year older at 17. So we're going to get rid of Zachary Wade here. Going to release him, unfortunately. We're going to sign Devin King. And now on to the games. First, we got a press conference. Will the opposition be worrying about you? Well, we'll be in the mood for sure. Thought the lads were excellent last game. I think they're ready to deliver again. Opposition will have their work cut out facing us in the form run. Can you keep this run going? Yeah, I think there's more to come. I mean, we dropped points against Crystal Palace in game 2. Pep's happy with what he's seeing from the team. Another transfer window's come to an end. Looking at the position of the season, you're comfortable with your squad. Absolutely. Got what we need. Happy with the cover I got in every position. Think the squad's good enough and deep enough to go a long way this season. I wouldn't mind another left back, but let's look at Who we're gonna start? Aguero, a little stamina's down. Gonna go. Season 82 sharpness for Silva. Mara 64, so I'm gonna give the nod to Bernardo. Sterling Foden is not in good shape at all. Sharpness is a 10. So we're gonna go with Ilkay. De Bruyne, of course. Rodri, Laporte, Diaz, Walker. Mendy's only in 7 sharpness. Ake, he can play left back. He has before, but putting him out of position. I'm gonna give it to. Well, we had another game coming up shortly. I'm gonna keep Mendy in there just because, we're facing Olympiacos in a few days. Normally, I would put Cancelo maybe on the left back side. He has played left back for City, but I'm gonna need him to play right back for Walker, considering we have to a game in just a few days from now. So bench looks good. Foden, Torres, Mahrez, Cancelo, Jesus, Ake, and Fernandinho. I'm not going to give any of these other young kids some time. And do we need to do any kit changes? I think we're good. Just going to go with the classic standards. And off to Anfield we go. Crucial game in the Premier League. Winner's going to be in first place. All by themselves. Hopefully it's us. The stage is being set. The players exchange pleasantries before the battle on the pitch begins. As you'll never walk alone, reins in from the crowd. We are underway in Anfield. Oh, big turnover by Ederson. Another turnover by De Bruyne. Big save by Ederson. And City is off to a terrible start. The pressure from Liverpool is paying dividends so far. And I have no idea what Ederson was doing right there. Walks it up and loses the ball. I don't know what that was. Fourth corner coming on. Another turnover right in the defensive zone. And Sterling turns it over, trying to cut in to get a better shot. And City will get their fifth corner. There's a tie game. Raheem Sterling buries one to tie it up at 1-1. What a touch by Sergio. And Klopp is not happy with that defense right there. As Sterling gets his first of the Premier League season. And now City is up to the press. Sergio gives City the lead. The press leads to the turnover. The counter. De Bruyne finds Sergio Aguero to tie it. Sorry, to give them the 2-1 lead. Blows it right past the keeper. And Pep is happy as Sergio gets his third goal of the season. And all is forgiven from Ederson. Oh, bad pass there by Rodri. Oh, see, just a tad too much touch, but he was offside. Barely offside there. Two to one lead going into the half. City fell behind early off a terrible mistake by Ederson. The early pressure really got to us, but we were able to settle down. We withstood the pressure and were able to counter, get a 2-1 lead. Possession 56-44 City. 5 shots to 3. All 5 have been on target for us, 2 for Liverpool. We've had 4 corners to their 1. Each been offside once. No cards have been given yet. In the second half, we get underway. No changes for City. Liverpool has not come out with the same intensity of pressuring. Now they start to pick it up. That's not who I said to pass the ball to. And Liverpool ties it. And another city turnover leads to a goal, this time by Jordan Henderson. Liverpool makes their first sub of the game. Goal kick was the call. Sterling picks off a pass. What are you doing? Sterling comes out to make way for Mahrez. I literally have no idea what my team is doing right now. This has been a piss poor performance. Especially from Ederson. Wow. What the f- I don't know where these passes are going. It's not the direction I'm holding my joystick. This is a rage slide tackling now. Terrible performance by City today. Inspirational performance there by Pep. I'm sorry, Kevin. As we now begin the Champions League. Again, audio is in stream mode. It has been temporarily muted due to YouTube and copyright. I don't think these are really 3 month trips. And because our game is on such short rest, we're not really gonna have any time to practice. Everyone is going to be just a rest day and a recovery day. So we have a press conference to attend to. Have to believe in ourselves. A lot of quality in the squad, but we're up against other good teams. Confidence will be very important. This is time for everybody, for the fans, for yourselves, the start of your Champions League campaign. How are you feeling? Confident you can kick off with a win? In opening fixtures like this, the form doesn't count for much. Anything could happen. We'll have to stay focused for the whole 90 minutes to avoid any surprises. Your city definitely looks stronger than Olympiacos. Are you pretty sure this is a game your boys will be able to win? Will it be one of your easier games? You can never be sure. Especially after getting waxed by Liverpool 5-2. Confidence is probably not the highest as it can be. And then again, we'll be playing Man United shortly after this as well. So Jesus gets the start. Ake is going to play for Laporte. Diaz is going to sit for Stones. Mahrez starts. Sterling starts. Mendy is sitting for Zinchenko. Cancelo is playing for Walker. Rodri is going to sit for Fernandinho. De Bruyne is going to get the start. Just some extra bench. Diaz will be on the bench. We'll go Garcia as well. Let's go. Where is Z? I started Zinchenko. It's probably we got another striker. Silva could play with Domingue, Torres mid to wing. Should be ready to go here. So let's get the Champions League underway now. The teams pose in front of the Champions League banners. And the Champions League is officially underway. And City starts off strong. Fourth minute, City already on the board with the rocket from Jesus. That is the absolute start they needed. Good form debatable after that Liverpool beating we were just given. Ooh, what a play by the defender there. Corner try, headed by John Stones, just bounces over the crossbar. And Jesus has come up large so far to start the Champions League off. Two goals in the first half. Nice pass by Foden, just onside, and again, finesse shots it around the keeper. His second goal in the Champions League puts City up top. 2-0 here in the 17th minute. Could not have asked for a better start, but where was this last game against Liverpool? Good play there by Foden. Press picks up here by City. Backwards pass, but Stones able to come back. Somehow ruled off sides. Way to get back by Mahrez on defense. Big first half by Jesus. I tried to actually pass that on the ground to him, but. Good defense by Zinchenko. Oh, he's going to be offsides. Yep. Oh. Try to actually get that over to Mahrez, but so what a first half by Jesus, a hat trick, goals in the 4th, 17th, and 34th minute. Only other game that's being played, Atletico Madrid is up 3-1 on RB Salzburg. 54-46 possession, 6 shots versus 2, 5 on target versus 1. 83% shot accuracy, 87% pass accuracy. 3 offsides, that's the big key for Manchester City here. Second half begins. Look for De Bruyne to be subbed off shortly, playing on short rest, and then again we'll have to face Man U in just a few days. And already have a big 3-0 lead. Actually, I'm going to take De Bruyne out now. We are going to put Ferran Torres in. We need to rest De Bruyne. Big game against Man U coming up. And he's already playing on short rest as we just played Liverpool 3 days prior. And the newly subbed on Ferran Torres gets his first goal in a City kit here in the Champions League. 4-0 on Olympiacos. And boy, is that young kid happy. Can't tell from the look on his face, though. Gives a thumbs up to the crowd. There is a little smile he cracks. Oh. You will avoid the card, though. Try to get it to Torres again. Going for four! And we're going to make a formation change here. We're going to drop to a 5-2-3. Some more defense. Torres, because we got Manu again coming up soon, is going to play there. Sterling will be replaced by Eric Garcia. We'll put him in the middle, give him some protection by Ake and Stones. Fernandinho and Foden are going to be in the midfield. I step up there, my Cancelo. Torres, second goal since coming on. He's had a great day. Let's see who else we have on the bench. We'll leave it as is for now. They're recommending Bernardo replace Mahrez. But we kind of want Mahrez for, I mean, Silva for next game against Man U. So I don't quite want to make that change and wear him out. What a play by Zinchenko. Foden! With a blast on top of the box. And a big, big rebound after getting waxed by Liverpool. A 6-0 win in the Champions League. Jesus gets the game ball with his first half hat trick. They actually had more possession than us, 53-47, but we outshot them 12-3. Jesus, man of the match with a perfect 10 rating. Then we have Phil Foden at 8.7. Then we got three guys with 8.1 with Mahrez, Fernandinho, and De Bruyne. And Atletico beat Salzburg 4-1 in the other Champions League game going on. Let's hear from Pep. Great win. Congratulations. And no question, all the headlines will be about Jesus' performance. Were you surprised to see him weigh in with the hat trick? A great performance and a great hat trick. But his true value is a team leader. Very happy to have him with us at the club. He's inspirational. Nobody expected Olympiacos to give us a serious test today, and the game went according to predictions. What will we take away from it? Concentration is so important. Defensively, we had much to do for long stretches of the game, but I thought the lads were very professional today. Didn't give anything away, worth the win. 6-goal win. Would you say you controlled the game start to finish? Well, yeah. Deserved our goals today. Very pleased to get forward right at the end. Great work ethic. Very pleased with the team. Work hard in training. See, so you have one notification. Looked for everything in Italy. Couldn't find anything. Let's go to Mexico. My videos are not edited at all. It's just all taken off stream. World class. I did not change anything from the Liverpool beatdown to Olympiacos. Boys were just playing very well. We'll have one training day before we face Man U at home, which will be the next video. Tied for second with 10 points, but Liverpool now 15 points, 5 ahead of the big tie between Tottenham, us, Arsenal, Newcastle, and Everton. 1 point above Chelsea, 8 Crystal Palace. Man U is in 11th with 6 points. 1 win, 3 draws, and a loss with a goal differential of 1. We are sitting at a goal differential of 6. So in our next video, you will see games against Manchester United. And then away game here, FA Cup matchup. And that'll be all for this episode. Thank you for tuning in, joining in, watching on YouTube. Until next time.